YouTube. Today we're going to examine a mystery of two tape recorders. These are both cassette recorders from approximately the 1980s. They're both made by General Electric. They both look almost exactly identical, but one is an adult tape recorder and the other is for children, and it's called a kidcorder. I have the box that this came in. You can see how it says kidcorder, and there is a child fascinated by a tape, and there is the tape recorder. It also came with an instruction manual. Now, both of these machines I purchased from eBay quite some time ago. This came with a package of tape recorders. I bought a bunch of them as a package deal, and it was used quite a bit. This came in the box that I showed you and has not been used very much at all. You notice that they are almost identical except for the case cover. This is obviously designed for children with the bright colors. This is obviously designed for adults with just the silver color and very kind of dull look. This says kid quarter on it, which is all it really needs to say for a child. This says things like automatic stop, General Electric, integrated circuit, and auto level control, because those are things that would be of interest to an adult. Now, what I've done with these two machines is I have completely cleaned them up. I have put new belts in the machines. I have corrected the motor speed on both machines, because these are modern tape recorders, so you can get into the motors and adjust the speed. I have aligned the heads. I have demagnetized the heads and cleaned everything in the inside so they are as close to optimal condition as possible. I did not do anything with the electronics. We're going to examine these two because I want to do a type of scientific research. This is a toy. This is not a toy. That's how these things were sold. Back in the 1980s, when these things were being sold, I remember seeing them in the stores, and the price varied between $24 and $32. I never went to a toy store and looked for the price on these. Now, the question I have in my mind, which is why I bought this, is this machine and this machine look identical, but because this is a toy, would it work worse or better than this machine, which is for adults? My theory is that since this is a toy and toys are educational, this machine should have very, very good sound, because the child listening to it, speaking into it, and so on, will hear his or her own voice and should hear it as close as possible to what other people hear so that the child can learn proper speech. The adult machine should do the exact same thing, but not because it's educational, because it is being used in so-called serious business. Obviously, if you were like a police department or a doctor or a lawyer and you were making a recording of a client, you would want to use this machine because it looks serious rather than this machine, which would look ridiculous in an office setting. So I did an experiment. Now, both of these machines have internal microphones. This is the internal microphone here. Here's the internal microphone here. And using just the internal microphones, I made a recording on this machine, took this cassette, put it in this machine, and made another recording. I want you to listen to the recordings, because this is quite a bit of a mystery as to which of these machines is better and which of these machines is the real toy. So let's listen to this tape. But before we do, if you like mysteries, take a look at this. I think you'll find it very interesting.
Thank you.
Now, before we listen to this tape playback, notice that I am showing you the Yamaha PSS-80 digital keyboard. And this is what was used for the recording made on both of these machines. Now, even though this has a special output, I didn't use the output. I wanted to do this the way a child would do it for this machine, so I simply did the same thing for this. All I did was I placed the machine here next to the keyboard and had the keyboard play back.
This is a test. This is a test of the General Electric Kidcorder cassette tape recorder. Here is a sibilance test. She sells seashells by the seashore. She sells seashells by the seashore. This recording is made with the built-in microphone. Now for a music test from the Yamaha PSS-80 Portasound keyboard. Concludes the Kidcorder tape recorder test.
Okay, now that was recorded on the Kidcorder, played back by the Kidcorder. The next part of the tape was recorded on the silver tape recorder, but it is going to be played by the Kidcorder.
This is a test. This is a test. This is a test of the General Electric automatic stop integrated circuit auto level control silver tape recorder. This is a test of the silver tape recorder using the built-in microphone. Here is a sibilance test. She sells seashells by the seashore. She sells seashells by the seashore. And now for a music test from the Yamaha Portasound PSS-80 demo song. Concludes the test of the General Electric Silver Automatic Stop Integrated Circuit Auto Level Control Cassette Tape Recorder.
Now you notice the tape is playing, but there's very little tape noise coming from this machine. So this was playing back. Now we're going to do the same thing, making this machine play back. So I've switched the positions of the machines, not simply because of the power cord here. So this is not functioning. This is the functioning machine. Here we go.
This is a test. This is a test of the General Electric Kidcorder cassette tape recorder. Here is a sibilance test. She sells seashells by the seashore. She sells seashells by the seashore. This recording is made with the built-in microphone. Now for a music test from the Yamaha PSS-80 Portasound keyboard. Concludes the Kidcorder tape recorder test. This is a test. This is a test. This is a test of the General Electric automatic stop, integrated circuit, auto level control, silver tape recorder. This is a test of the silver tape recorder using the built-in microphone. Here is a sibilance test. She sells seashells by the seashore. She sells seashells by the seashore. And now for a music test from the Yamaha Portasound PSS-80 demo song. Concludes the test of the General Electric Silver Automatic Stop Integrated Circuit Auto Level Control Cassette Tape Recorder.
Notice that there is very little tape noise from this machine when the tape is blank. So here is the challenge for you, having been patient enough to listen to all of that. Which machine do you prefer? Which machine do you think has a better sound? Think about the quality of the voice, think about the sibilance, the S's, and think about the music, especially the wow and flutter. Okay? And what I'd like you to do, if you could, wouldn't mind doing it, appreciate it very much, is leave your comment and say, which machine did you think sounded better? Now, just take a few minutes to do that. You can pause the video and then write a comment and then come back and start the video up, because what we're going to do is an examination of both of these machines. While they seem to be identical cases on the outside, we're going to find some surprises when we look inside. The machines are very different on the inside. But before we look at that, the back covers come right off. They are not connected in any way. And they are pretty much identical, so that the black cover could fit on the bottom of the red and vice versa. They seem to have been molded from the same plastic. But now let's take a look at the mechanisms and the circuitry, and we're going to see things are quite a bit different. First, we'll look at the kid quarter. What we see here for a drive mechanism is a fairly standard Chinese type of drive system. The Chinese have been manufacturing these tape recorder mechanisms for quite some time, and they have a very standardized way of doing it. Usually there's the motor with a belt going to a what I call a silver dollar flywheel, and then there's a secondary belt going to a idler that works the fast forward and the rewind. And this is what we see here. And here we see the circuit board, and it's a fairly complicated circuit board. If you take a look at it, the shape is very similar to what we're going to see on this machine in a minute. But it seems to have more components on it. So that's what this appears to be. Now if we go over here and take a look at the other one, the silver one, it's a very different type of mechanism. Notice that it's still a Chinese design, but there's a plate over the capstan, and the belt comes and wraps around this idler and then around the capstan itself. Now notice that the circuit board here is considerably simpler than the circuit board here. Notice that there's a lot of traces here. There are not so many traces here. And you can just see that they're different components. Now I've had this all apart and taken a look. This has many more capacitors on it than this does. The speakers are identical, and most of the functions are exactly the same. You can see that there's a very different approach in the mechanisms for the two machines. Notice there's a back plate, there's no back plate. This capstan is removable, this is locked in through a clamp on the other side. So what does this all mean? Well, I'm going to put them back together and give you my analysis. Personally, because I'm sitting here with the machines, listening to them actually live, I prefer the sound of the kid quarter actually a little bit over the sound of the silver adult machine. And it's kind of interesting that I would do that, considering how this is made. For one thing, I've got this into the record mode. There's no power right now. This has a magnet for an erase head. This actually has an electric erase head. Both the machines seem to have AC bias. It's hard to tell because there's no AC bias coil that I can find on the board if it's being used. If it's DC bias, it's pretty darn good DC bias. Both of these machines use an old style trigger for the auto shutoff, which only works in play. My finger is there showing the trigger, and over here my finger is showing the trigger. And so it is not full auto stop on either one of these machines. Overall, this machine seems to have less wow and flutter than this machine. And we know from some of the Chinese designs for the cassette transports, some of them are very, very precise. And wow and flutter ratings are as low as 0.12%, which is almost inaudible. They can go as high as 0.3% in the less expensive machines. So it depends on how they built the transport. Overall, this seems to have a slightly wider frequency response than this, but this seems to have a little bit clearer sound. This seems to have a little bit more noise in it. This seems to have a little bit less, but it depends, and when you swap them back and forth, it's almost impossible to tell. Both machines were inexpensive. Both machines were nothing even close to being high-end or top-end. But to be quite honest, if I was making a recording using this internal microphone, I think I would go for the kids' quarter over the silver machine. But my question to you is, what did you think? Please put a comment in the comments section of the video and say what you felt about the sound of these two machines. And another question is, if you were buying a cassette recorder as a toy for your child, now you have to imagine it's back in the 80s, because nowadays we have MP3 players and smartphones and all of that. But if you were going to buy a cassette recorder for your child, would the kid quarter be the thing to buy, or would you buy them this? Thanks for watching the video. Please stay tuned to clydesight for more vintage tape recorder videos. Bye-bye, YouTube.